In this video, I'm gonna show you how to make your light-based images look amazing in just four simple steps. If you love making this kind of portraits and it's all about light, then this is the video for you. In four simple and easy steps, I'll be showing you how to turn your image from this to this. If you want to edit this same image together with me, you can download this image by clicking the link in the description of this video. Now let's get started. Step 1. Enhancing the light. First, add the adjustment layer exposure. Bring up the top slider a bit. This increases the brightness. Make sure not to go too much with this. When it looks okay, change the blend mode of this adjustment layer to luminosity. This blend mode is making sure the adjustment layer only affects the lightness of the image and not the colors or anything else. Now, you can hide the mask by selecting the layer mask and hitting Ctrl or Command I. Take a soft brush and decrease the flow a bit so you get a soft edge. Now paint on the brightest spot on the subject, which is in my case her cheeks and a bit of her hair. Make sure you don't paint on the black areas too much. You might not see it yet, but this is destroying the image later. Step 2. Adding glow. To really make the light pop, you need to add a nice glow to your image. There's multiple ways to do this, but I prefer this one. Make a new solid color and make it about the same color as your chosen light source. I have two, the right and the left, pink and blue. I start with the pink one on the right, so I try to match that pink color. Then change its blend mode to linear dodge add. This brightens it up in a better looking way. Now hide the mask and paint with a soft brush over its mask. Make sure the flow values are very low again so you get softer results. Again, don't go too wild with this, just a subtle glow. Step 3. Camera raw filter. Select all your layers, right click and select convert to smart object. This will put all these layers together in one smart object and it will appear as one layer. Now go to filter and select camera raw filter. This is very similar to Adobe Lightroom, so if you prefer Lightroom over this, go ahead and use Lightroom. There's a few tabs here. In the first tab, bring up the clarity and the texture a bit. This will sharpen up the image and give it a nice local contrast. Then you could also make the light shine even brighter by bringing up either highlights or whites. Then you can also increase shadows a little, this will make the shadows less dark. Then go to the second tab. Here you see curves, which works exactly the same as the classic Photoshop curves. I like to take out some of the black by making a shape like this. Left is dark, right is light, and I want to take out some of the dark. Then go to the fourth tab and select luminance. Here you can make a certain color brighter or less bright. I decide to make my blue color a bit brighter, like this. Then head over to split zoning. Here you can select your highlight color and your shadow color. I want my blue to be the shadow color, so I select that and bring up the saturation a tiny bit. Then for calibration, this allows you to change the color hue per channel. This is all preference, just try them out and decide for yourself what works best. For me, this is fine. And step 4, iris blur. This step is optional, but with portraits, I like to add an iris blur, which is sort of an edge blur. Go to filter, blur gallery and select iris blur. You enter the blur gallery's workspace now. In the middle you see a circle. These blue dots represent the starting point of the blur, and the edge represents where the blur is at its most. You can change the shape and everything to your liking. Also, the amount of blur is completely up to you. And there you go, that's how you can easily make your light-based images look awesome in just minutes. I hope you've learned something new today. If you did and you liked this video, make sure to hit that thumbs up and consider subscribing for more content like this. And if you don't want to miss anything, make sure to hit that bell. And then I hope I'll see you in my next video.